The White Goose by Tasha, Tudor. The little white goose was lost. She had slipped away in the moonlight between night and dawning. Robin missed her when he went to call the cows. They had not been waiting at the gate as usual. The grass was silvery with frost and moonshine. Over the hill he could hear the cowbells, and that other robin, the echo of himself, calling from the mist. And could that be the calling of the wild geese from the river? Robin stood still and listened. The feeling of something behind him, something he wanted to run from without looking back, crept over him. But he turned, and there on the grass lay a white feather. Beyond lay another, and another. Robin forgot about calling the cows. He forgot about the warm fire at home. He forgot about his mother cooking breakfast. All he saw were those white feathers lying in the moonlight. All he heard was the calling of the wild geese from the river. He turned off the cow path, down across the pasture, through the woods, down to the marsh where the cattails grow, he ran. There he stopped. Beyond lay the river. The honking of the geese was deafening. Then all was still. Robin parted the rushes and peered out. There they were, the wild geese. But among them stood a little girl, stroking their sleek necks. She looked up and laughed at Robin, beckoning to him. He felt the cold moonlight run through him as he listened to that fairy laughter echoing across the river. He felt the dark eyes of the wild geese watching him. The little girl turned toward him. The geese silently made way. "Come," she said, and took his hand. Again Robin felt the cold touch of moonlight and shivered. "Come quickly," said she. "It will soon be daylight. Here's a fine gander. Jump on his back and fly away with us." "Fly away with us," echoed the geese. But Robin hesitated. "I'm thinking of home," he said. "I know," said she, "but come. We will fly over great forests and mighty rivers. All the birds of the air will talk with us." But still Robin hesitated. "I can see my little sister smiling in her cradle," said he. "I know," said the little girl, "but come, we will fly up that shaft of moonlight to the most wonderful place you ever heard tell of, the hidden side of the moon." "The hidden side of the moon," echoed the geese. "Oh, I can hear my mother singing in the kitchen. I cannot come," said Robin. Then Robin saw tears running down the little girl's face. She turned sadly away and faded into the mist, but in her place stood the little white goose. Then all the geese rose into the air on thundering wings, and Robin was left alone, standing in the moonlight. Now some say that people with pointed ears like Robin see things that aren't really there. Maybe if you had pointed ears, you too might hear that little girl's laughter and look into her fairy face. You might even fly up that shaft of moonlight to the hidden side of the moon, who knows? Strange things are said to happen when the wild geese fly between moonlight and dawning.